I see often very prominent people who have large followings, and they get a lot of hate and harassment through Twitter, through, you know, those profiles where it's like Hacksaw 358, and they have 6 followers, and they've tweeted 8 times, and they have an egg as a profile picture. And I'll see people with thousands of followers retweet the hate and harassment they're getting, as though to say, and I know the purpose is to say, see what we're dealing with here. And I actually recommend against that. I am not going to, I don't help anything with my followers putting that out to so many thousands of people when the original person had no visibility. First of all, there's the philosophy of, why are you giving them that visibility? Shun them, cut them off from the light and the oxygen. That's what they want, and you're helping them. But second of all, I actually don't think you're helping online discourse to take something that 6 people saw and send it to 12,000 people if it's full of hate and harassment. At that, at what point are you contributing to hate and harassment in our online community? You can whistleblow, like, I think one time's sufficient. Hey, here's this one thing I got, and I've gotten it 118 times. I don't think constantly retweeting this stuff is useful. And I think it actually increases the negativity in the online space. And a lot of people think that you should call these people out, but they're not people. They're eggs with you know, pseudonyms, right? So you're not calling anyone out. You are just giving them more visibility than they deserve or ever would have gotten. And so that's something I wish more people who had a platform were a little more conservative about.